You had your instructions in the dressing room. You both know exactly what I expect. A clean championship rematch. Just obey my commands and protect yourself at all times. Punches right here are not considered low. Right here are not considered low. Touch gloves. Good luck to both of you.
The time has come for redemption or validation. Will Robson Conceição prove that he is rightfully the WBC Junior Lightweight Champion? Or will Oshaki Foster right the wrong from July 6th? We're seconds away from the first bell, getting it started here. Top Rank Boxing on ESPN Plus main event. Mark Kriegel, Tim Bradley, and Bernardo Osuna coming to you with all the action. And Tim, there's so many ways this fight can go.
Yeah, it's the first round right now, and it's very important for each guy having that nervous energy to not get emotional, you know, in the start. You get emotional, you're not thinking. You know, I think we're going to see a tactical battle in the beginning. You're already starting to see shock, already starting to put a couple of punches together. Seems to got his range already. You see more sense of urgency by shock.
He said, look, the first time around, you didn't see me in my southpaw stand. I thought I was doing everything so well and so clean that I didn't need to do anything and show anything of what I'm capable. Well, he's going to need to do it tonight and not leave anything to bring home with himself, well, other than the belt.
Well, I always say, if you can do more, why don't you do more? Yeah. I mean, you know, just don't settle for less. Do
nice
more.
Right there from Conceição. Yeah.
And looking back at it now, Shock is saying to himself, like, I could have done more. I should have done more. He lost his title. And I think tonight he's going to do a lot more than he did in that first fight, from what I'm seeing as of right now. And Conceição, on the other hand, Conceição, he's trying to press forward. He's trying not to let Foster get into a good rhythm or a groove. Nice check hook right there from Foster.
Yeah, it was a good feint from Robson, but the counter check hook was better from Foster.
Good defense right there from Conceição. And nice stab jab. See, the head will move, but the body will stay still. Now the body can get out of range. However, I like the way that Conceição now is attacking that body of Foster. He didn't do that a whole hell of a lot the first time around.
See the three punches that Foster threw landed on the gloves of Conceição, but just the fact that he's got offense on his mind and that he's willing to throw those shots is already different than the first fight. This is round 13 for these guys. Nice left hook there from Conceição.
Nice step back out of range. See those body shots right now from Conceição. Again, he's looking to have some effect later in this fight, hoping that Oshaki slow down a bit. But again, he's paying more attention downstairs than upstairs, because again, that's the biggest target to hit.
He only landed 11% of his punches in the first fight, did Conceição, on his way to becoming world champion. A lot more effective so far. It's a different fight. They're in the center of the ring.
Already.
Headbutt there.
It's a very close round right there. Very close round. Don't know who you gonna give that round to.
I'm gonna give it to the guy who came forward.
There you go.
I mean, that's what happened the first time around. Let's take a look at the counter left from Robson Conceição. Probably the best punch of the round.
You see right there the high guard right here, and you see him step back, knowing that Foster's gonna step in with some offense, making him pay for his aggression right there. That was a nice setup right there from Conceição. Just keeping those hands up, stepping out of range, understanding that Foster has to be a little bit more busy, anticipating that shot and landing his own. Nice little counter.
Okay. You did right. That was a good round. It wasn't bad.
Bobby Benton was honest. He said it was a good round. It wasn't bad. But the other thing Bobby Benton, his Oshaki's trainer, says, look, I like boring fights because that means my guy is doing what he needs to do and he's not getting hit. Yeah. But I want consistent judging. And you got to understand, you can't count on that. You don't know what each of these three judges like.
Big shot. That was a nice shot, nice little level change in the loop and left hand. You're absolutely right. I mean, you try to win these rounds again decisively. You have to. And Konsei Sal, he's an Olympian, Olympic gold medalist. He's not spooked by this southpaw stance. He's seen many southpaws throughout his career. Fought even Shakur Stevenson.
Yeah, you talk about a slick southpaw. That is the definition of it. When you see a picture in the dictionary, Shakur Stevenson.
Fought Robesi as well.
Yeah.
I mean, he's not spooked. He understands that right hands need to be landed and left hook as well. But again, when Shaka's sitting back, the one that's dictating the pace is Konsei Sal. See, again.
Now, none of that Konsei Sal is in southpaw stance. He's like, you want to play games? Let's play games.
Yeah, he didn't feel comfortable. No. I didn't think that was smart at all. Again, none of those shots landed at all. Again, but again, it's the optics. It's the way it looks. And the more experienced judges, they will see that. However, an inexperienced judge will be counting those shots.
Be careful. You see the Canelo feint from Konsei Sal there? Throws that left high and then came over with the right. Good defensive responsibility from Oshaki, though.
Again,
that right trying to get around the guard.
Yeah, he's trying to get around the guard again. Now, Oshaki's catching those punches.
That was the same shot, but now it's from Foster.
But again, this is a tactical battle right now for both men. Both men are doing everything there. Nice body work right there. That was a good body shot right there. Nice little bolo shot from Konsei Sal. And then Konsei Sal doing the smart thing in the inside and tying up Foster and not letting him work, not allowing him to work. Ooh. Again, not a whole lot of effective punches coming from Foster either. Foster should take his attention downstairs. He's having a hard time hitting upstairs, so you take your attention to the chest and also the body.
Konsei Sal throwing some wild shots out there, not putting himself in a bad position, just making Shaki think about where it's coming from.
And uncomfortable, yes he is. And again, you see Konsei Sal lands another right hand down to the body. And all right.
That's a good counter there.
It was a good counter around those guards. Yes, it was.
Not a great work rate either from Oshaki Foster here through the first two rounds.
Who you get at round two?
Same thing.
Konsei Sal.
No, yeah, who landed the best shots? Doesn't have to be much because
Think about
Shaki's not throwing
speed
a lot.
And have fun, okay? Listen, yeah, exactly. And when you're southpaw with the offset left hand, okay? All right. Just shoot it quick like a decoy and then slide to your right and shoot the left hand.
Yeah, he's looking for that right hand. You keep pulling it at him with the space, okay?
He's trying to home run right now. You know that. Yeah. It's okay. And remember, at the end of the round, let's try to finish strong a little bit, okay? All right. Just get busy.
I gave you the win?
No. Yeah.
And I'm saying, how it's you good. See the first round?
I got it 1-1. 1-1? Yeah, that round was too close. The first round was beautiful.
Okay, yeah, we got to think of it like that.
Yeah. Well, Upson Konsei Sal told us, Tim, I was dealing with iron deficiency for the first fight.
That's
I was anemic. I had body aches, my arms hurt, my legs hurt. I couldn't pick up the intensity of my training. Tonight, you're going to see the best version of Upson Konsei Sal, and I don't know that Foster can keep up with my pace. And that remains to be seen. 79 punches thrown by Foster, 75 by Konsei Sal so far. But landed 22-24 in favor of Foster. He's trying to pick up here in round three.
If I'm in Foster's corner, I'm telling him he needs to pick it up.
Yeah.
We need to pick it up. We need to dictate the pace. We need to control this man and not allow this man to come forward. We need to bag him up. We need him to change his game plan because he's gaining confidence as he's pouring it on you, or at least attempting to.
And that was enough for him in the first fight. I don't know how much it's going to also be on the minds of the judges, all the backlash that the last three judges got for the decision the first time around. You know, they're human beings. They see the media. They see how their colleagues are treated.
See the athleticism of Konsei Sal, even though when he punches and you see him out of position. It's like autocorrect. He's able to get out of the way. That's awareness. That's experience.
I mean, he's always keeping his hands moving in this fight, though.
Yes.
Like, he's really making Foster think about
what's
he going to do with that hand that he's boloing around. And
ooh,
he's going to throw that right.
Good right hand right there from Casasal as well. Foster again bagging up along those ropes. He's getting out work right now. That's what's happening. Good shots right there from Foster coming around that guard. Again, Foster's going to have to fight a little bit more tonight,
man. Box out of there.
He's going to have to fight a little bit more tonight.
Stop.
Can't be sitting cute and being on the outside. These rounds are too close.
Yeah. Life's about lessons learned, Tim. And Shock has to have learned something from that first fight and how the judges saw it. And I don't see that adjustment as of yet in terms of picking up the pace.
Oh, he's trying to get close. He's definitely trying to get close. And now he's starting to work that body. Both are changing body shots.
But in a fight that was so close last time, you can't give rounds.
Oh, nice shot.
That was a nice overhand right there by Shock.
Again, who's being more consistent right now? Conceição, all those shots. He landed some really good shots in this round. Again, Conceição eluding a lot of those punches, having fun coming back with shots like that. I mean, man, that's appealing to the judges. It really is. And that's why I'm saying, Oshaki, put them together. We don't know how they score in this fight right now. This is very close rounds by both men.
All three have been swing rounds, if you were to put it on balance. And neither guy can afford to think, I've got this.
Time!
All right, next week, we move over to Norfolk, Virginia for a homecoming. Keyshawn Davis and the DB3 brothers will be in action. Gustavo Lemus, can he upset the man who also is close to a world title shot? We'll find out in Norfolk, Virginia.
Keyshawn, the businessman, Davis!
He's got every tool in the arsenal.
Look at this offensive assault from Keyshawn Davis!
When Keyshawn wants to turn it on, he can turn it on.
Open right here.
He's ready for this moment right now.
It's not just Keyshawn Davis, it's Kelvin Davis. His younger brother, Keon Davis, making his pro debut. Troy Isley, the Olympian, taking on Tyler Howard. And Abdullah Mason, one of the best prospects in boxing today, against Johan Vasquez. That will be our card next week in Norfolk, Virginia. We talked about adjustments. Who's going to make adjustments coming into this fight? And I'll tell you that Robson Conceição has connected on 72% of his shots to the body. And that's a concerted effort, Tim, compared to 29% connects to the body from Oshaki Foster. How do you stop or slow down a mover? You go downstairs.
Go downstairs. Absolutely. Again, I always tell you folks at home.
Ooh, nice flurry
nice
there.
Combination. Just letting those hands go again, getting into range and just being busier with his shots.
I think the more Conceição does this, the better it's going to be to wake up Shock. That's what you have there, the 1-2.
Again, but the problem with Shock is he goes into that Floyd Mayweather defense, and he leaves that lead hand down, and it's hard to work from that position that he's in. He's in a compromised position. If he's not shooting the right hand,
don't punch.
Uppercut,
no.
On that back foot, I mean, and then that lead hand is down, he can't really use it like he needs to. Keep his hands up, so that way when he needs to go to the jab or the left hook or something, or even the left uppercut, it's there.
Stop.
Look, you're facing a guy, Robson Conceição, who had almost 430 amateur fights, Tim. He's seen every style in the game. So what you have to do is get after him. You can't let him take the step forward. That's how he won the title in the first place. He let a little Karate Kid
move. Hey, he having fun.
He is.
Conceição is having fun.
He's loose.
He's energetic right now. Foster right now is still trying to find his mark. He's making a lot of those shots miss. He's catching some on the gloves. But, man, just the work rate again. That tenacity right there. That's what the judges are seeing. Good body work right there from Shock.
Stop. Be careful. It's all right.
What do you do when you get hit to the body? You say, it doesn't feel good. Let me get some.
And this is a technical battle, man. I mean, it's a high chess match. It really is.
You called that, Tim. Is that one?
Good shot. 1-2 right there.
Ooh, nice defense from Shock, but you're allowing Conceição to once again dictate the pace, making Shock fight his fight.
Stop! Don't punch. No, step back.
What's that like, Tim, when another guy puts his chin all up on your back and is trying to, like, lean down on you?
Putting a lot of pressure on your legs, a lot of pressure on your neck, your lower back.
Is that 1-2? Nice counter right there from Oshaki.
But that 1-2, again, getting rolled. You see the nice little roll from Oshaki, but he's countering with one shot versus three shots coming at him.
That's a perfect punch, you know, for what? For judges' view. Because what did the judges see? Did he roll it in their perspective?
Absolutely right. Good counter. It's a nice round right there for Oshaki.
Listen in.
You caught your groove, son. Good job, okay? That was a beautiful round. You're seeing everything, right? I got you. Kick your feet up, relax, sit back.
Yeah, I'm saying all that shit.
Okay,
yeah.
But look, so let's do this. Every time he shoots now, we throw back at him, okay?
Okay.
Because he's not hitting you. So just even if you miss it, you fire back on his ass, okay?
Yeah.
All right.
Right hand, the hook behind you.
Gotcha.
Hey. Hey, just getting warmed up, baby.
Take a couple deep breaths. He's breaking down already.
Yeah,
he's getting tired already.
He's just barely breaking.
Keep that heat on him.
He's shit to keep tracking me off of.
And he's holding, too.
Holding like a motherfucker.
Yeah.
Yep, you can step on my pound.
Walk the circle when he grabs a hold of you, okay? Don't let him hold you. Get your hands free, okay?
Keep turning.
One more.
Don't forget about the coffee shop, son. Okay?
I got it. Have fun now.
Seconds out.
All right.
Back up.
Through the first four rounds, 63% of Conceição's landed punches are to the body. 72 was what he had through three rounds. So it's diminishing slightly. To put it to comparison, 30% of Foster's landed shots are to the body. What does that mean on Mark Kriegel's unofficial scorecard?
It means close rounds, but three rounds to one Robeson Conceição. I don't know, you see a guy better with the belt? I don't know if he's 20% better, 30% better, but he is a more confident fighter. He's using his length. He just seems like a more confident guy. Spoke to Bobby Benton. He goes, I want Oshaki to be more aggressive, especially during the rounds.
Yeah, he might have hurt him with that shot. I'm not sure if he was off balance right there. Small little shot on the inside. Looked like Conceição was okay.
But it's those shots that Foster has to be better at connecting because they're there for him. And that's what his trainer, Bobby Benton, said. Look, I don't care what, but even if he misses you, I want you to fire back. And that's what we're seeing from Foster. That is what was lacking in the first
fight. Box out of there. Punch out.
That's the tactic I used to be against Manny Pacquiao in the first fight was when he throw, I got to come back. When he throw, I got to come back with something. It was just basically answering that call. So if Manny looked like he's dominating, well, he no longer looks like he's dominating because guess what? I'm coming right back. And that's how I was able to pull off a decision. It's the optics, baby. You got to know how to win.
Absolutely. Foster got caught messing with his hair there, and Conceição tried to take advantage of it.
Step back.
Conceição's even defending himself from the referee, Mark Nelson.
Yeah, it may seem like Conceição's breaking down, but I'm telling you, he got a ton of heart, and he's going to let those hands go no matter what. He's not going to let go of that belt. It's taken him this long to get there. He's going to keep swinging.
Nice.
He's going to keep letting those hands go. That's for sure.
But Tim, that's twice this round that Foster's messing with his braid. That's all taped up there.
Stop! Don't punch. Be careful.
Can't be messing around with that braid, man.
Your hands have to be either be defending or punching.
Not a lot of whole lot of jabs coming from Foster either. And then when I say that, he throws fighting throws a jab.
That's a good round
jab. That's a really
Foster.
Good jab.
That
too.
Jab was clean.
Really good jab. Back, snap the head back of Conceição. Foster now looks like he's starting to get his rhythm and timing down of Conceição. That offense has slowed down from Conceição.
because he's making him miss and he's making him pay.
Again, that's another missed opportunity. Right hand, yeah, could have came over the top. That's what I'm talking about, man.
Three in a row, Tim. Three lazy jabs. Not the jabs he was snapping earlier.
Yeah.
Three lazy jabs, yeah, that he missed on countering. Let's listen into Luis Dorea. Yeah.
You gotta combine those punches with the hook.
Tim, you talk about close misses. Check this right hand.
Left hook right there on the inside.
Ooh, look at
rolled his head.
Reaction.
Did you see that? Man, boy, his instincts, his eyes. I'm telling you, he has some great eyes. Great eyes. But, man, we need some more CP. And I'm not talking about Christina Puncher, although that's the homie. I'm talking about counter punching. That's what we need.
Well, Shockey's trainer said, I got you up 3-2. I mean, I thought that was the most definitive round so far in favor of
Nice right hand right there. Good right hand right there from Kase Sal. Two right hands. Partially rolled. One, the second one was partially rolled by Foster. But it's starting to get, they starting to get at it right now. It's finna get spicy.
Yeah, Foster just landed a nice overhand right as well. Wasn't as clean as Kase Sal's, but both guys are going to have to start digging
Stop,
deep.
Stop, be careful. Hey, come on, guys. Keep it clean. Keep the round clean here.
Yeah, you got Kase Sal. He's going again in the inside. You see him tie up. He's not allowing Foster to work on the inside. Then he gets out, shoots his jab right away. And again, just being very reactive, responding to every moment, every
Stop,
low
be
point
careful.
In the fight for Foster.
Look, man, Kase Sal's looking
Keep
like Gumby out there.
Don't grab
as he gets
him.
A gunning there. You know, he's like very flexible, like all over the
place.
Oh,
he's elusive. He's extremely elusive. Again, I told you it's a technical battle. Both guys defensively are superb. Kase Sal, he uses his reflexes. He slips and rolls his head, get down low again. And a lot of times he's out of position. But again, his awareness and understanding that a shot's going to come back, he's able to avoid a lot of punches too.
And you know what he's doing this time that he didn't do the first time around is he's hitting shot on the shoulder, on the arms. It just hit him anywhere. Just don't miss like you did the first time around.
Oh, I thought shot for a minute. I thought he got buzzed for a minute because his legs buckled, but he just bent his knees. Again, Oshaki coming forward, but he ain't throwing no punches. All right, if I'm in the corner of Oshaki Foster, this is what I'm telling him. You got to be first and you got to be last, kid. You want your title? That's what you got to do. You got to be first and be last. Don't sit back and depend on your defense. You got to fight this man. You see in the inside, he keeps tying you up because he doesn't want to be there. Kase Sal is not a great inside fighter.
True.
So take him there.
I mean, this is exactly where he wants to be.
On the outside where he's shooting those long arms and he's able to mount his attack with those straight punches he likes to throw. Kase Sal, right?
Yeah.
Nice hook.
Box out. Box out.
See, this is where Shot could do some work on that inside when he's grappling.
Now step. Now step. Man.
Man, he's got some amount of Augustus to him today, some drunken
oh,
master.
Oh, yeah, he got some drunken master in him right now, Kase Sal, right? You're right. Good analysis.
Take a look at
him apart, but you're still missing opportunities to fire, okay?
So far, look at the percentage of shots landed by Hobson Kase Sal. 27%, not impressive, but neither is 29%. But when we look at what happened in the first fight, he landed just 10.8% of his total punches, and Oshaki Foster landed just 25% of his total punches. There was 435 punches thrown by Foster, 701 thrown by Kase Sal. So the pace is slower for, and it's at the pace that Foster wants to fight at, but the efficiency for Conley Sal is a lot greater than the
because
first time.
Because he's throwing more punches. That's why. Throwing more punches at the right time. Again, Foster, yes, he's slipping and rolling, and he's deflecting a lot of these punches. But again, it's the optics. It's the way it looks in the refs. I mean, in the judges' eyes. One guy's been very effective coming forward. That's just it.
You know, we talked about adjustments and changes. We saw the power punch percentage for Oshaki Foster, just the less than 2% uptick in that.
Box
you have to hit the guy hard, so
yeah.
It looks like you're trying to win this fight.
Yeah. Stop! Be careful. No.
We know what Shock is capable of doing.
You see the jab that was thrown, and then you see the combination coming right back from Conley Sal. Again, he's just getting outworked. Got to work a little bit more. Every shot don't have to be perfect. Just need to let those hands go. Hit the body. Attack the body. You see the push-off right there from Conley Sal. He doesn't like that pressure.
Look, man, he's got two fists coming at him, and he's got a ponytail flailing back and forth on him that he's worried about Oshaki Foster. And you see the ESPN Bet Live money line, -115, -115, and it was wide for Foster when the fight started. So a way better performance from Conley Sal than the first fight.
Come on, guys. It's all right. Don't turn around. Watch the back of the head here.
-500, now it's -114 each. Foster was a prohibitive favorite coming in. And that line has changed.
Another right hand to the chest. That's a scoring blow. Good inside work right there from Foster.
When does he pick it up?
So he goes southpaw right. Look, he goes southpaw because he's buying himself some time. Now he's making Foster think. That's just to slow down the pace. A smart maneuver right there from Conley Sal just to get a little breather. Good jab downstairs.
I don't think we've seen Conley Sal go southpaw, have we?
No.
Good shot right there. That's a new wrinkle. Nice quick shot there by Foster.
Man, Foster keep pulling on that, pushing that ponytail back. It's getting in his face, man. It's stopping. It's stopping his momentum, man. It's making him think. He's thinking about his ponytail getting it out of his face and not thinking about punching and landing.
As long as it doesn't hit Conley Sal.
And I remember it was Paulo Malignaggi. That cut his hair.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Was it against Cody?
Those were extensions. Yeah.
Yeah, he did have extensions. He cut his hair.
Remember Franchon Cruz DeZern?
Yeah.
When she had her weave and they asked her, what do you want? Your hair or the belt? He's like, take this hair off in that belt.
Absolutely.
Very firm and
stubborn.
Oh,
okay.
All right, Tim, this seventh round is hard to judge, man.
Another close round.
We'll listen in. Rob, you got windows clear.
Get
behind the jab, but you got to bring something behind it. But tonight he is landing almost 11 punches. That's comparatively to 12 punches around and under 8. All right, let's take a look at the ponytail that.
Ooh. It almost hit him.
Yeah. Almost hit Robson Conley Sal, pokes his eye or something.
Hit him in the eye or something, right?
You got me. You know what I'm saying. Fuck that. No coach. Don't coach because you can.
I wasn't about to start coaching.
Okay. And at the end of the round, you got to turn it up, okay?
When Shock started to put punches together, it took some off the power. He was having success early on. But that finish to that last round, I believe Conley Sal had a great finish there. Again, just letting his hands go. Anytime Shock get in range, he just lets his hand go. He's just outworking Shock.
And Bobby Benson wants him to
box out.
Try
box
to steal the round. So you got to close strong. And you see what
again, you see him mess with that hair.
With that ponytail. Nice right hand there from Oshaki Foster.
Again, he messed with that
punch
hair
out.
Again.
Box out of there. Stop.
Ooh,
don't
that
punch.
Was a nice lot of body holding. Shot, though.
A lot of holding right there from Kansei Sal. Hasn't been worn yet. Oh,
nice left hook there from Foster.
Another left hook.
Stop.
Jumped right into that.
You're holding. No, 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 man.
There's a warning finally for holding against Kansei Sal. Mark Kriegel, what did Bobby Benton have to say in Oshaki Foster's corner?
He said, forget about the hair. He says, Kansei Sal is getting tired. He's holding a lot. I need Shock to
there.
Touch
punch
him
out.
On the way in. Once he's in, he's safe, he's good, but it's getting in is the hard part. Just touch him on the way in.
Nice body work, quick combination punch. Punching here from Foster. The tide of this fight is starting to change in favor of Foster. Can he capitalize on the momentum?
Box out.
It kind of does look like Kansei Sal is getting a little tired.
Box out.
He is definitely getting right, a little tired, but I wouldn't, again, I won't count Kansei Sal out. He got a lot of heart. I remember we thought that Navarrete had him out.
Yeah.
He came back in that fight. So
dropped twice.
He might be taking off this round right here. That's fine. Laying off this round, not doing a lot of work, so that way he can come out next round and be more explosive. But this is a clear-cut round right now in Shock's favor. And it's just, again, pressure, applying pressure, touching, getting physical on the inside. Forcing Kansei Sal to tie up. And that left hook has been sensational. That right hand of Kansei Sal is down. The chopping right hand right there from Kansei Sal. The attempted left hook right there from Shock.
Right.
But
okay.
Got to close the distance. As you can see, Kansei Sal don't like pressure. He don't like it.
He never has, Tim, whether it's Valdez or Navarrete.
He likes his space.
Yes. Because he's got those long arms, and he, even though he has a 2-inch disadvantage in reach against Oshaki Foster,
nice
left hook, and then a right hand from Foster.
But you still got to, when you're walking forward, you still got to be on your P's and Q's, because Kansei Sal, again, he can box, and he knows the right moments to stop, hit the brakes, and then let
like
his
that.
Hands go. Yep.
With a clean right hand from Hobson Kansei Sal.
What was the jab at from Shock? Shock ain't even using the jab. He's just trying to walk in.
And what did Bobby Benton tell him to do?
Use the jab.
And he said, close the round strong, and he walked back the final 10 seconds after a good right hand from Hobson Kansei Sal.
Absolutely right.
Let's listen to Bobby Benton.
Stay small. Let's hands up walking down now. Touch shots. The shot shots are working beautiful. They're setting up the big shots, right? And you're still seeing everything, so you're not going to worry about nothing. Just don't jump back too far anymore, okay?
Yeah, that's what I feel like I'm doing.
Okay.
You're not running and holding that.
So just work your catch and react, okay? All right?
Yeah.
Stay tight, stay small, and work your catch and react, okay?
Right.
Do it from now on. Walking down. You're going to break him. He's already holding way more than you.
You got to use your speed. Take a deep breath. Don't stop. You have to keep working hard. Breathe deep.
So I'm looking. If I'm shocked, right, and it's a close battle, I'm looking over at Kansei Sal. I know how I feel. And I see him weakening, but I'm looking over like this, and I see him taking those deep breaths in. I know he's tired. He's worried about something, taking those deep breaths in like that. What you worried about? You've been doing that from the first round.
Mm. All right. Mark Kriegel's been doing something since the first round of that scoring this fight. How's it look after eight?
76-76, four rounds apiece.
Stop.
I do agree with Bobby Benton. Kansei Sal's tiring a little bit. He was great early. But I still see Oshaki Foster leaving some loose change on the bar.
That would be the analogy that R. Mark Kriegel would use.
Leaving that meat on the bone, huh? Yep.
That stab jab from Kansei Sal.
Box out.
Here Foster trying to be physical with him, too.
Nah, that was Kansei Sal right there just pushing him back. Again, trying to smother the work of Foster. Touch. Oh, nice
body
counter.
And right hand from Kansei Sal.
I'm telling
box
you.
Box out, guys.
Kansei Sal.
There you go.
He's spontaneous. Again, he will drop his head and he'll come up with a slinging with a
box
left
out.
Hook or a right hand.
Stop. Be careful. No, be careful.
Extremely spontaneous. You got to be careful. When you think you got him, you don't got him.
He's anything but predictable tonight. There's a 1-2 once again from Hobson Conce. Sal, he tries to dig with that left hook to the chin, but good.
Ooh, good body work right there. Awesome body work.
Yeah, from Conce Sal.
Again, Foster got to keep that pressure on him. Use that jab, come forward, let those combinations fly. And focus. Focus Fox on one out. Thing. Focus Fox. On that body. You see your man starting to fade. Continue to punish him downstairs.
28 landed shots downstairs for Foster. 49 landed downstairs for Hobson Conce Sal. Nice jab after making Foster miss from the Brazilian. Nice straight right from Foster, but Conce Sal rolling with
him. Oh, he's slipping and rolling and making his body small.
What does that do, Tim?
Man, it's hard. He's elusive. You know, you can't land on the target. It's difficult. And then he steps back and fires a 1-2 like that, partially blocked. But again, it's the optics. It's the way it looks.
Stop. Stop. Stop.
And there's a difference in how Conce Sal is moving backwards. He's moving backwards, positioning himself to set up a shot.
Set up a shot. And Foster's putting the pressure on him, but he's not landing enough punches. Okay, here's some offense coming from Foster finally.
A nice right hand, though, by Conce Sal. Not much landing clean, but there's more work coming
Box
from
out.
Conce Sal's side once again.
Yes.
Hold it, Mark.
The work
yeah, but look, don't let him. Push his head up in the fucking air.
I know,
but get his head, get it up quick. Because you know it's coming as soon as he gets close to you, right?
Yeah, that's how he's
and on the inside, face. You're beating the shit out of him, okay? It's good.
Yeah,
we need all these three, okay?
Turn it up. Hey, I'm going to turn it up on him, son. Got it?
Hey, drink this one.
Be great. Hey. Get 11, 12. Let's go, Chuck.
Hey, if you walk to your right, whenever he grabs you, your hands will come free right away, okay?
Right.
Got me?
Yeah.
All right. Pick it up now.
You're being creative with that shit.
No, I know. But don't let him.
Okay.
You're better than that. You're the best fighter in the fucking world. Act like it, okay?
Round 10 of a scheduled 12-rounder, and there is former WBC junior welterweight champion Regis Prograis.
The Rougarou.
Yeah, the Rougarou here to cheer on his stablemate, Oshaki Foster. And Tim, in the corner, finally Bobby Benson said, hey, we need all three rounds here. And here are the odds up state. It went back up to minus 500 Foster, plus 350 Conce Sal.
Conce Sal put his chin on the shoulder of Foster, digging in his shoulder.
Yeah.
Trying
that's
to end
I was
him.
Telling, asking you, what does that do? But
he's trying to bruise his shoulder.
Stop! Don't punch!
That
was no,
a nice
no, no,
right
no, 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 no.
Hand that connected earlier in the round by Shock. The inside work
Stop.
Is exceptional from Shock.
Keep your head up. Come on, come here. Come on, give me a clean round here. Be careful, guys. Let's go out by some.
Defense,
but no offense.
Yeah,
good defense, but no offense, man.
Same story as the first fight.
It's like when you make a move, right? What's the purpose
Stop.
Of the move if you don't counter? Yes, I get sometimes you can't counter, but when you're in range, you should counter.
Ooh, nice body shot from Foster. That opens up the left hook to the head.
See, getting outpaced. Just getting outpaced.
There's Shocky on the inside.
Shock is looking for one hard shot, whereas you have Conce Sal just letting his hands go and saying, I hope this lands.
Yeah. There are tons of punches thrown. They're right there, 430 to 417 in favor of Conce Sal. And there's only four punches.
Oh,
there it
Big
is.
Big shot.
That's what Shock is capable of doing, sending a shot through the legs and the body of Robson Conce Sal when he lets his hands go.
He's looking for that one shot and he finally found it, that right hand.
You see how electric the crowd gets Will he be able to capitalize? He wants his belt back. What is Foster willing to do here? Bobby Benton told him, I need all three rounds to win this fight. This is how you win the fight. This is how you get your belt back.
Looks like Kase Sal now got his legs, got his wits back. Again, moving, but it's a perfect opportunity for Oshaki to step on that gas. That right hand is available for him. Nice inside slip right there from him. Coming up with that nice little swivel jab. Good hook as well. Yep. Kase Sal starting to fade a little bit. He's fighting back off of instinct and heart. Big round right there for Oshaki.
I would say that was the best round for Oshaki Foster.
To the body, okay? All right.
Probably one of the most definitive rounds.
Don't forget about that, okay? Because he did all that shit just so you wouldn't fire on him. Hey, give me that. Give me the water. All right. Yeah, he's ready to go. He's ready to go. He's fucking dead tired. But let's step on. Let's get him out of here. Let's don't let these judges do this shit to us, okay? Don't give him a chance.
Championship round, son.
That's it. Two more rounds, son. 6 minutes.
Show him right now.
You got this, son. You got this. The speed shot's the one that hurt him, too. Right? So do it again.
Come on. Tá bom, Robinson? Esses dois rounds de luta, Robinson. Tá bom? Inspira fundo.
Are you good?
Inspira fundo. E acredita em você. Com a mão da frente. Levanta essa guarda. Vamos lá, vai no coração, porra.
You have your heart. Come on.
Vamos lá, mão na frente trabalhando.
Show me what it's about. All right, here we see. That last round was a solid round. A 6-punch differential for Oshaki Foster. That puts him at a 9-punch advantage overall through the first 10 rounds. And I love what Bobby Benton says, like, look, those speed shots hurt him. Don't let the judges do it to you again.
Look at the confidence now, the exuding confidence coming from Oshaki now. Now he's starting to believe he knows he can hurt Kase Sal. You see him starting to pick up the intensity. He's going for it. He wants a knockout.
And this is where he's at his best. It's what he had to do against Eduardo Hernandez to become a world champion in Mexico, down on the cards in the 12th round, and he did it.
Uh-oh. Did he hurt his hand right there? Oshaki.
Just shook it, huh?
He shook it, yep.
Or was it just to fix his hair?
Maybe he shook his right hand after he threw it, and both exchanged right hands. Kind of got tied up awkwardly. Let's see if he uses it. Yeah, he's still using it.
Don't punch. I got you.
So it might have felt uncomfortable for a moment, but he ain't got time to worry about that if so. Again, he throws another right hand. Good inside work right here. Shock just letting his hands go right now. And then here come Kase Sal again. That hard determination and will to win.
Box out, guys.
Nice body work from Foster. Kase Sal answers in like.
Oh, this started to turn into a fight, man.
Man, that
this is good.
Ponytail is just throwing me off.
Yeah,
nice combination
exactly.
There.
Because that dang ponytail, dealing with that ponytail. I understand like you like your hair, man.
Box out, guys.
Shoot, I like that
there.
Money in that championship more than I like some hair. You can always grow your hair and also get extensions if you want to. Shoot, cut that stuff off. No, I can't.
But other people can.
Yeah, I can't grow no hair, man. I'm not getting that fake stuff in my hair. I'm nice. Not doing those implants.
Nice body shot there.
Yeah. Good inside work right there.
Punch out.
Oh, nice short shots on the inside. Now
hands
he's starting to work
guys.
His hands.
Punch
that's good work right there. And the judges are seeing right now. They're seeing Kase Sal tie up on the inside.
Look, Timmy, the start of the fight, it was minus 500 Foster. Then after the sixth round, it was even at 115 each. And then it moved to 2,000, a minus 2,000 favorite now for Oshaki Foster. But, Tim, you can't depend on the judges to see the same thing.
Absolutely not. You gotta go for the stoppage right now on the back end of the fight. He has his man hurt. Need to let his hands go on the inside.
Nice.
Again, it's mid-range. It's not all the way inside because then you allow Kase Sal to do that.
Don't let him smother you.
You can't allow him to smother you.
There's a flurry inside, but not any efficiency from Kase Sal.
You gotta turn out of that corner. And see, and right now what you gotta do, Oshaki gotta get physical on the inside with this man if he's gonna get off those ropes. Got to get physical. Pull down on the head. Make the referee do his job. That was good work right there from Kase Sal. Smothering the action.
Oh, Oh man, we're gonna listen into the corners as we lead into the 12th and final round.
Quando faz o clinch, não segura ele não. O árbitro tá tentando trabalhar, tá parando não. Não abre o braço. No clinch, botei no clinch. Porque o árbitro tá deixando você trabalhar no clinch. Aí tá batendo você. Muito equilibrado.
This is a very even fight.
Mas tem que ser.
Alright, put him on his fucking ass for me, okay? Alright? You got it. Put this boy on his ass, okay?
Let him hold. Eat his ass up this way.
When he tries to close out, slide to your right. Quick.
That boy up there, they hold
him. Good luck. Last round.
That's the only reason why he survived, man. He know how to survive.
Take a deep breath. Take a deep breath. Come on. We need this fucking round, okay? Don't give up no fucking round.
Finish out big in this one. Finish out big, son.
Go, son.
Mark Friedel through 11 rounds. What does your scorecard look like going into the final?
105, 104, 105, 104. Six rounds to five. Oshaki Foster, whatever you want to say about that first fight, this is one hell of a showing.
I still think both guys have more to give, and I hope we do it here in round 12. We've seen moments of it, glimpses of what they're capable of doing, Tim.
Yeah, but when you have two highly skilled fighters like that, you know, that great defensively and offensively, that's what you're going to get. You're going to get this type of mix of fight.
We saw with Better Be a Bevo.
Yes, exactly.
This is a high-level chess match.
Ooh,
nice
that,
left hook there from Foster.
Look at Foster letting his hands go again. Staying true to himself, using that shoulder roll, coming back with right hands, and he's shortening his shots up. Now instead of throwing one shot, he's starting to throw combinations off of that roll.
Don't say Sal digging downstairs to the body. Something he's done throughout this fight.
But again, Shot got to get real physical right here. You want to get yourself off the ropes. You can pull his head down, make the referee step in. You can do something. You can push him off. You can nudge him. You can walk him back to the center of the ring. Tie him up.
Come on, box out of there, guys.
See, Kansei Sal right now, he's just working. He's dead tired. But what he's doing is he's smothering Shock. He's not allowing him to be able to stand with his offense. And then he's stepping back, getting range, and then he's hoping Shock get close. Because when he does, he's going to look to tie up again.
Shock Foster looking up at that clock momentarily.
Come on, box out of there.
1.5 minutes left.
Box out.
Look, there he is, letting him tie up again.
Freak.
You being on Shocky Foster, you can't allow him to do that. And the referee hasn't done anything about all that holding that Kansei Sal has been doing this entire night. A lot of holding.
And those are arm punches now, Tim. There's nothing behind the Kansei Sal shots here in round 12.
Yeah, but he's there for the counter. I mean, he's so heavy on his front foot. He's tired, dead tired. Counter with that right hand. And I know Oshaki's tired, too. He don't look tired, but let those hands go, man. Your belt is on the line.
Break. Nope. Stop.
It was a low blow from Robson Kansei Sal moments ago.
Look, sometimes it's not about technique and all of that, man. It's just about fighting. It's like how bad you want it, man. You got to go get it.
Well, he
go
says,
take it.
My motivation is remembering sitting in those FEMA trailers. Losing my mom.
Not sitting in the corner.
Yeah, sitting in jail. That's my motivation. Well, he needs to dig deep here. And someone needs to differentiate themselves over the last 30 seconds. And this is how you
do it.
Here
he come. Here he come. He's looking at the clock to turn it up.
Again, holding.
A lot of holding.
I mean, this is a round both guys need. And did Foster do enough to win this round?
I think he has.
Really?
I do. I think he has.
Close fight once again. Both fighters raise their hand in victory, but only one can come away the winner. And I still don't know who won this fight. It's been 24 rounds, Tim, and there's very little separation between these two.
You telling me? I mean, this is one of those fights where, again, you see one guy trying to outpace the other, then one guy landing something significant, and then, you know, Shock had a really good closing round. I think it was 11th round. He had a really good 11th round, man, where it looked like he had Kansei Sal out, but the experience again of Kansei Sal, knowing what to do at the right time, he started to smother him. He didn't allow him to work and use that offense and use that reach.
you know. But again, you see shots like this, that offense, high work rate coming from Conte Sal. And I understand that on the Compy box, they have similar, let me see, what is it about?
We'll get to it, we'll get to it.
Yeah, I'm thinking, like, how many punches are thrown right here? But there were some good moments in this fight for Shock as well. Landed some nice left hooks. He actually hurt Conte Sal. Whereas Conte Sal, I don't believe, hurt Shock at all during the course of this fight. Better battle than the first time, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Here are those CompuBox numbers. And pretty much it comes down to 297 landed from Conte Sal. But to me, it's the percentage landed. You talk about an 11% efficiency in the first fight. He's at 32% this time on power. It's twice as much as it was for the first fight, where it was 16%, 40% though.
But look at Shock.
Oh, Shocky Foster. Mark, what does your unofficial scorecard look like for this Foster Conte Sal rematch?
115-113, Oshaki Foster. I had him winning the 12th round. You know, I think he's been really great on 12th rounds the last couple years of his career. Very close fight. Hobson Conte Sal showed me more than I ever thought he had. Certainly more than we thought he had a couple years ago. Tough, tough guy.
And when you take a look at, they're taking their time with the scorecards, and that always makes me think, Tim, what are we dealing with here? But you saw that Oshaki Foster, this time around, he outlanded Hobson Conte Sal with the power punches, 120-94. That is a huge difference comparatively to the first fight. So that could be the difference in the scorecards tonight.
He fought with a sense of urgency. You know, you can tell. You can see right from the gate. Pep in his step. And he had a nice close to the fight as well. So might be a draw or could go to Foster.
All right, let's listen in to Mark Chinook, who has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds here inside Turning Stone Resort Casino, we go to the judges' scorecards for the official decision. Max DeLuca scores the bout 115-113, Foster. Tom Schreck scores the bout 115-113, Conte Sal. And Eric Marlinsky scores the bout 115-113 for your winner by split decision. And the new two-time WBC lightweight champion of the world, Oshaki Icewater Foster!
You talk about a close fight.
The end, yep.
And it was the closing rounds that Oshaki Foster proved that he wanted it more. When his opponent wilted, he